Welcome to what us old farts at Weekend Gamer hope will be a regular feature where you can join us into a journey of discovery through four decades of video gaming. I had tried to come up with a hip and exciting title for the feature, but when Decca Games was the best effort I could come up with, I decided to scrap it and steal someone else's idea. So get ready, for now that's what I call tennis. Decades. Pong was released to the unsuspecting world in the form of Atari's coin-operated arcade cabinet all the way back in 1972, but its origins date back even further. Tennis for Two by William Higginbotham was created in 1958 and was played on an oscilloscope. But Pong itself was almost a straight rip-off of the Magnavox Odyssey game Tennis. Atari's version of Pong was to become the de facto standard. The footage you're watching now is from the original Atari coin-op, but if you want to play it these days, you're well advised to choose one of the many versions on the Atari Classic Collection packs, such as this PlayStation Atari Anniversary Collection. Matchpoint from Sion was released in 1984 and to this day is still one of the best ever tennis games. Voted at the wonderful position of 69 in the Your Sinclair official Top 100 Spectrum Games, they called it understated but beautifully animated, with a wide range of skill levels and options to ensure that players of all ages, talents and attention spans get never-ending joy out of it. And who could argue? Just look at those graphics. It even has an animated crowd. But as always, it's the playability that counts, and whilst it may not have the range of shots that the modern games do, or the real player names, it does, in traditional style, let you rename the players to reenact those classic games of yesteryear, or just put a sword-wielding rabbit in his place through your pixel-perfect precision power play.
Ticket to ride, white line highway, tell all your friends they can go my way, pay your toll, sell your soul, pound for pound, cost more than gold, the longer you stay, the more you pay, my white lines go a long way, either up your nose or through your vein, with nothing to gain except killing your brain.
Is it getting better?
Play.
Or do you feel the same? Will it make it easier?
When Nintendo released Super Tennis in 92, the machines were now more powerful and were capable of arcade quality graphics and much more in-depth gameplay. It's a shame I didn't think about that when I first loaded it up though, as playing it immediately after Matchpoint, I forgot that the SNES had more than one fire button, and trying to beat the little red-skirted tennis hall with a single shot type was almost impossible. Go on, trip her up as she walks past. But once I got the hang of the different strokes, I had her running around the court chasing the ball like a kitten chasing a mouse. Though she probably won't mutilate the ball and leave it close to death, whilst nipping off for a nap like our feline friend. Super Tennis was a revelation, and took tennis gaming to another level. The beautiful cartoony graphics had more character than the earlier games, though their friendly look belied a pretty tough game. With 8 tournaments, on 3 different playing surfaces that actually felt different, a choice of singles or doubles, 20 characters to choose from with different styles of play, Super Tennis set the standard and held the crown for a full 7 years, until Sega started the biggest ever tennis franchise, but more of that in a minute.
Have you come here to
Wouldn't that be great if Jesus was one of the playable characters? The Virtua Tennis franchise began in the arcades in 1999, but it's best known for the sublime Dreamcast offerings. The game we're looking at is Sega's newest effort, Virtua Tennis 3 on the PlayStation 3, and it's loaded with features and customizations. You're able to tweak the look of your character and their styles of play before taking them on the road in a career-style tour of the tennising world. There is a training academy available to teach you the basics, but that's a bit dull, to be honest. Far more fun are the minigames. A staple of the Virtua Tennis series, there are 12 different minigames in the PS3 version, allowing you to smash robots, knock down pins, avoid giant balls whilst collecting fruit, and loads more. Some of the games must be unlocked as you play through, but they're not here as a distraction. The minigames are essential training that builds up your character's skills and have a noticeable effect on your gameplay. It's this mix of wacky fun and serious simulation that's become Virtua Tennis's trademark, and it's only when they veer too far towards either direction that they get it wrong, like the overly stuffy Virtua Tennis World Tour on the PSP. But even with the minigames, if Sega got the actual tennis wrong, then the game would be a waste of time, or just a wee party game, which actually might be quite good. Career mode is built around upskilling your character and taking on opponents in ranked competitions. This moves you up the world rankings and allows you to battle bigger and better tennis stars. Low-ranked matches aren't too difficult, as VT eases you in with a very relaxed learning curve. The AI of computer-controlled characters varies greatly depending on the ranking, and in the early stages, you'll find it easy to fool them into running frantically to reach an anticipated cross-court stroke, only for you to power the ball into the opposite corner, leaving your opponent scrambling on the floor. And it's this progressive improvement that drives you on in the game, with the goal of reaching that elusive number one ranking. But to be honest, all this has been the case since Virtua Tennis 1, so what is there that makes the PS3 version worth getting? Well, nothing really, just better graphics and a few more minigames. But the Virtua Tennis franchise is so strong that you don't really need anything new. If you still regularly play on your Dreamcast, then Virtua Tennis 2 is a cheap and very cheerful game that'll meet your tennising needs. But if you're looking for a great next-gen tennis game to play on your shiny new HDTV, then Virtua Tennis 3 is an excellent choice that may not have moved that far forward since its genesis in 1999, but in some cases, that isn't such a bad thing.